Hi everybody, this is Annandal. This is a bonus tutorial Tuesday for the month of July. At the beginning of the month, I shared with you this tutorial for making the style of doll pens. This is going to be another tutorial focusing on making pens, but this will be different because with these pens, they're going to have a piece of lead here at the end, as well as a cap to be able to cover that lead. So with this cap, you can actually safely cover the lead in case you want to put the pen inside of your doll's pocket or their bags. That way you don't get any powder or any accidental smears on their resin or on their clothing. So I have two pens here that have this cap style. And here at the bottom, here are the pieces that I'm going to use to make this type of pen. At the very end, I've got a mushroom cap button that's just going to clean up the very end of my pen. This is a jewelry rivet that's going to hold that mushroom cap. Here is a brass tube, and here is a skinnier tube that will slide into this thicker one. On the skinnier tube, I've wrapped a gold jump ring so that it will stop right there. And this will be my main body of my pen. And at the skinny tube, that will hold the piece of graphite lead. This graphite lead, I've cut off from a drafting lead holder. This lead holder usually holds the graphite here. You can buy these at drafting stores. You can buy the lead separately, so you don't actually have to buy the lead holder here. And with the piece of lead, I've wrapped a thin piece of masking tape. I have this skinny roll of black masking tape. And that masking tape is so that it can fit snug inside of this tube. And that's how it holds my piece of graphite lead. Here, these pieces will be making my cap, and you want to make sure that the cap is either the same length or preferably a little longer than this portion here. It needs to be able to cover the skinny tube as well as the very end of the lead that's exposed here. So you want to make sure that whatever bead you're using, it's the correct diameter to be able to fit on top of the lead, as well as be able to cover this half of the pen. I have a rivet here that will help extend this bead a little bit to make it the correct length. Just like the previous tutorial, this is another clock hand that has been bent at a 90 degree angle, and the watch hand will sit at the top of my cap, like that. And at the very top of the cap is just another button to clean up that end. Once again, we'll be using the two types of glues. Here I've got E6000 and some super glue. As I mentioned, there's the masking tape, which I've used on the lead. I will also be wrapping a layer of the masking tape inside the cap. That way it creates some friction and it has a stronger grip on top of the pencil. I have some toothpicks and an area to put out my glue. I've got my cutters and my pliers for bending the clock hand here. I'm going to have, just like the last tutorial, a little pin that will run through my pen to make everything straight and keep everything aligned. And lastly, I've got my tweezers to clean up any glue. So now we can start putting these pieces together. Thank you.
Thank you.